Good afternoon, everyone. This is Stole Your Sweet Roll coming to you with another build tutorial. In today's video, we'll be finishing up the structure of cabin number 2. But first, we're going to start by fixing a few mistakes and omissions from part 1. We've got a lot of work ahead of us, but before we get started, I've got to say thank you to everyone out there who subscribed to my channel. Together, we've reached over 1.5k subs, and I want you all to know that I appreciate all of your support. So, without further delay, let's get started! First up, we're going to prepare the front of the build so we can fix the alignment of the chimney and then add in the stairs and railing. To do that, we need to remove part of what we built in part 1. Off camera, I moved the roof piece around and I also deleted the front corner section of the wall so I can move the chimney once the foundation is removed. Get a friend to help you out because we need to break the porch and the half wall to the side so we can remove the merged foundation. Once you've removed the foundation, we need to temporarily remove the center two roof pieces and adjust the chimney placement. If you're happy with how your chimney looks, just ignore this step. Once everything is right, have your helper break the conduit supporting the chimney and then break the half walls where the steps are going to go. Next up, we need to use the contemporary porch foundation and raise it slightly above the top of the half walls. This will allow you to snap in stairs over the broken halves. Be sure to snap an extra foundation to the side so you can remove the placeholders from the stairs. We will now repeat the process for the stairs that we used on the front for the back porch. Now, let's add in our railings. By placing a foundation to the side, we can lower its position and build a barn half wall down below the foundation line in the places where we want our railings to be. After we've got them in place, we'll break the barn walls, remove the floors, and then snap in the new floors, then repair, replace, and re-break the half walls. I know it's a confusing mess, but it just works. No, we'll repeat the process on the front and build the railings for the front deck. Now it's time to snap the merge foundation back in and rebuild the front. We did this like 50 times in part one, so I'm pretty confident you don't need me to read you through this. Now that we've fixed the mistakes from part one, let's move on to the walls and roof and wrap this build up. It's not going to be a cakewalk. Be sure to have the blueprints from part one handy because it's going to get complicated. And if I'm going too fast, remember, YouTube has a playback speed option. This video is going to be long enough already. Now, let's go ahead and start snapping in these walls. Be sure to snap them to the foundation and not the half walls on the outside, because they'll be a pain to fix as they'll become dependent on each other for support. Now, we're going to prepare to place two barn half walls below the foundation level to dress up the back wall of the house by merging them with a glass wall. This is a bit tricky because we have to adjust the foundation height in an area that's surrounded by other parts that the foundation will want to snap to, as well as parts that will need to be broken from support. You can make this easier in your build by simply snapping the walls in at the same height as your railings, but for some reason I wanted to do things the hard way, just to have the wall end up 5 pixels lower. Now, let's go ahead and add in the post for the covered section of the back porch by using the upper floors as a temporary snapping point. Now for the fun part. It's going to start off easy at the back, but when we start blending the offset roof with the rest of the roof, things are going to get mental, and it's only compounded more by Bethesda's horrendous snapping restrictions. You'll see as things progress how much I went through building this roof. I honestly can't even find the words to explain how it's done. The best thing I can do is show you, and when you try to replicate it, refer to the blueprint images from part 1, and what I show in this part of the video. You'll definitely want a helper because there's so much to break that a flame trap will literally drive you mad. In order to snap in the top arches, we're going to use the top of a slanted roof as a snapping point. This is one of those areas where Bethesda has made things a lot harder than they need to be, since they made it so slants and other walls will not snap to the bottom side of a roof. This becomes a major issue at the front of the house, when I have to add in the top arches there, and I end up having to wrestle around the front offset to get it done. Now we're going to move to the sides of the cabin, and placing in the ceilings. We'll be blending three different offsets together, so pay attention to where I'm snapping the parts in, and be sure to follow the blueprints that I provided. Right here was when the reality set in on me that I'd have to tear the front of the cabin down again just to finish the roof. And it's all because of the restriction on wall snapping. But hey, it just works, right? Wait till you see all the hoops I jumped through to finish this thing up. As you can see, I'm really avoiding finishing the roof, but this is a pretty important step too. When all the walls are built, there's a gap at each side of the offset, so to fill that gap, just stack a few rustic corners and fit them in to cover the gap. Moving on, go ahead and break the chimney and finish removing the front walls of the cabin. It's time to finally button up this nightmare of a roof. As you can see, I'm going to use scaffolding to place in the top arches. There may have been an easier way to do this, but at the time, I was running out of wit and building dumber by the second. I end up using a long string of roof pieces to disconnect the support from the arches, but there's, well, probably an easier way. At this point, I was 2 hours into this wonderful build, so my mind was pretty much gone. Now that the top arches are finally in, get your helper to finish breaking the rest of the roof. We're almost done. Just a few more roof pieces left to fit in. Then we can add in the fireplace and rebuild the front. Be sure to toss a coin to your helper because they're the real MVP in all of this. The last four roof pieces have to be offset by one half, so place your scaffolding off of the offset foundation at the back of the cabin. The roof is finally done. Let's button up the last few details on the structure. We're almost there. In true Bethesda fashion, it seems we've encountered another it doesn't work situation. Turns out the slanted wall is colliding with the arch. Well, we know what to do. When it doesn't work, just punch it until it does. That usually solves most of my problems with this game. Now, we'll build the fireplace. Now, let's repair everything one last time, then dress up the odds and ends and marvel at our empty cabin. Wow. For something that could be so simple, there sure is a lot of work involved. It's been one heck of a journey trying to put this tutorial together for all of you to enjoy, and I hope you found it useful and entertaining. So, if you like what I'm doing here and don't want to miss out on future build videos and tutorials, be sure to give this video a like and a comment down below. Also, if you haven't already, subscribe and ring that bell icon so you can get alerts for all of my new videos. Once again, I want to thank all of you for all of your support. So, until next time, this is Stole Your Sweet Roll, signing off. Have a wonderful day, and happy building.